Hey everyone, welcome back. This is Brooke. So today I am going to go through, let's see how far we get. We have three more tins from the estate sale collection that I want to get through because I have a 16 pound Shop Goodwill lot that I won. That I want to dig into. So I want to get these pieces out the way so that way we can open up that box. I have the Presidium over there. I picked this one because of this lipstick case right here that looks very old, and I think there's something in there, so pretty neat. We'll see how far we get with this tin and see if we can get any others opened. But let's get to it. So I hope everybody had a great week. It's currently Friday night. I am able to talk completely now without not slurring my words. So let's just get right into it and push that over there. Let's see what we have in these little boxes. So I am going to assume that this is another tie bar. I believe we already had some. It's got a little blue mark right there. And this one says 1220 or KGF gold filled and AWO or AWC. So that's interesting. The little infinity knot right there. It's pretty. I think that's what they call it. So this must be a box of men's items. That looks like a D. You're not going to be able to see. It's very hard to see. But there looks like a D etched in there, initial. There is some markings. I think that says S&S. I'll have to look that up because I'm not familiar with men's brands. But yes, it says S&S. So, not sure who that is, but we'll look it up. This is a pin, Safe Driver Award, 2 years. And it does say 1/20th gold filled right there. That's neat. Yet another, these big cufflinks, they have like this little bend. That says H.A. and Co. I don't know what H.A., but I will look it up and I'll put it down here if I find anything on it. Another teeny tiny little, could this be like something that they put on their ties, maybe? Not sure. It's got a lot of teeth in there. Huh. Interesting little box to start off with. Okay. Let's see. So we have a little pendant. Looks like a shark with some crushed up, maybe turquoise. There is some markings right there. I think that's a 91. And that one's pretty much worn off. It looks like we have another one, which is a dolphin and a heart pendant. Yeah, it's got the same markings on the back. If I can find anything, I will put it on the screen. We have a cute little pair of earrings with a matching necklace that says Monet. Okay, it looks like it's in, everything looks in brand new condition. Very nice. Like the silver tone. Everything is very well kept. Not sure if this is an, you know, an older piece or newer. Kind of, to me it looks newer just because of how nice it is. But yep, says Monet right there. Very pretty little set. I like the pendants too, the shark and the dolphin. Okay. So, this is really cool. Does have a lipstick in it. It says Whiting and Davis International. I have heard of that brand before. I think we've actually found a necklace from them at one point. So, I wonder how old this is. Yeah, it's used. But, very cute case. I do like that. I like the mesh. Gives it, you know, vintage look to it. So these are wood earrings. Okay. They have some plastic, very vintage looking earrings. We have these little, these are by Trifari. And they're just little tiny clip earrings. Probably just hug around the earlobe is what I would say. These are very pretty. I like that shiny blue. They're plastic. Silver tone screwbacks. Another set of screwbacks. Got two little rings. I don't see a maker's mark on these. And last but not least, what does it say? Made in USA. So just little pink enamel pierced ear earrings. Okay. Nice to see some name brand items in here. Looks like we got some Coro. That's pretty. It has, to me, it looks like little glitter flakes inside of it. That's interesting. Okay. And then these are very pretty. These say, I think that says long, let's see. Yeah, it says long craft. So I have no idea about that brand. I've never heard of it. Very pretty. Probably just glass. Yeah, they got a foiled back on them, but very pretty. They do shine very nice under the lights. You see a lot of pins in this box. Look at that. No maker. I'm not sure. Let's see. I had to move the Presidium, so I'm not going to be able to get it on camera, I don't think. Let me see. I can try. Yeah, this is barely moving on the glass line. So, but the stone or this piece of glass right here has a lot of fire to it. That one is very nice. Okay, so we have a big, looks like you have a little bird in the center. It is curved, so maybe to go on a scarf or, I'm not sure, gotta be careful because that will cause some damage right there, but it's very nice. It's gold tone, does have some, probably just needs to be cleaned, very dusty. We got a little bracelet. Okay, so this one is Coro. Silver tone, really good condition. Has like a leaf pattern on it. I don't know. I cleaned up my whole space and I have no idea what I did with my measuring tape, so. Probably a 7 or 7.5. And this cute little pin with the faux pearl in the center. And this one says, what's that say? Gold filled, 1/120, 12K. That's cute. Nice little pin. There's another one. That one is Trifari. Kind of has that matte gold color right here. I don't know. I am a fan of the matte gold. I do like it. A little different. This one's pretty. Love the filigree on the back there. These cute little rhinestones in the center. So we have, this pin has faux pearls. All of the coating, unfortunately, is coming off on these. All the rhinestones are there. So that's a shame that it's not holding up too well. Other than that, and there's some glue that is coming off as well. No maker, but it is pretty. Okay, what do we got in here? Alright, so we got a little crystal right there that's come off. These are Listener. Listener, little acrylic clip earrings. This is like a very pale yellow. And then this is a magnifying glass. On a necklace, which is beautiful. I love this, actually. I might have to keep this. We'll see. But just it kind of, I don't know if it's actually glass. It kind of feels, I mean, it might be. It just feels like plastic to me, but that is really pretty. I do love that. And we got this little teeny tiny rhinestone that popped out. So we'll put that over to the side. All right, so these say cufflinks. Yes, they are. Very nice. They have a lot of sparkle to them. That's very interesting. Well, those are very pretty. Okay, got another pin with matching earrings and a bag. So gold tone, you have faux pearls. And then you have matching clip earrings. These say Austria. And the metal is lightweight, feels very nice. They're not heavy at all. Nice pieces. I do like that. Alright, so we have a silver tone, nice size pin here. I don't see, oh no, it's by JJ. There's the marking right there. Did we have a matching pendant? I'll have to go back and look because I swear that we had a matching pendant to this. Very nice condition, looks good. Look at this. This pin is huge. It's the size of my hand. I don't know. I mean, I'm pretty sure that's gonna be a faux pearl. You got some glue that's coming off. Silver tone. I don't see any makers on it, but that, I don't think I've found one this big before. This is pretty impressive. That's nice. Looks like it has some shell or mother of pearl back there. A scarf clip. And that says West Germany. Yep, West Germany. Okay, very nice. All right, so this one's a little different. We got another pin. It has some cording wrapped around. Looks like it's in good condition. You have gold tone. I don't see any makers on the back. That one's nice. That one's got some weight to it as well. Oh, look at that. So that looks like, it kind of looks like a tiger's eye, but it has lines going this way and across. Yeah, it might be a tiger's eye. It's very pretty. I don't see a maker on it. It is silver tone. Looks good. Now look at this one. This one is definitely different, and it's by that say Natalie? I think it says Natalie. I've never heard of Natalie before, so I'll have to look into that as well. Lots of brands. It's amazing how you see so many different brands. It's amazing. Alright, so we have this really pretty rhinestone necklace. So you have clear and black. All the rhinestones there. I think we have a winner. That's good. So there's the back. It's got a little bit of wear, silver tone. Tiny little hook on the back. Very nice. Very pretty little vintage piece there. Looks like we have a locket. Nope. Gold tone. Very nice. You have a little bracelet with a bunch of writing. So this says Italy MOD DEP 24 karat gold plated. So I'm not sure what this is, or, you know, this right here kind of reminds me of Gucci's logo, but the G is not supposed to be upside down, so maybe it's a replica, a very bad replica. Not sure. I'll have to look into it and see. But it's an itty bitty tiny little bracelet that you can open like this. Interesting. All right, so we have Monet. These are silver tone metal beads that are on a chain. Very, you know, choker collar style necklace. Love the closure on this one. Just push it down like that. These have a nice feel to them. They don't feel like they would scratch or pull at all when wearing it. And it's not heavy. Wow, look at this. Big green stone. Let's see what the Presidium says. Yeah, it's just showing glass. Kind of has like a bamboo style surrounding, but very pretty. Okay, we have some more of the beaded earrings. These are in a gold tone for pierced ears. We have this necklace, very pretty blue rhinestone here in the pendant. Love this, and it's 1928. Okay, has a barrel clasp on it, little rope style chain, beautiful little pendant. We have another rose. I think this makes the third or fourth that we've, Giovanni. So let's see. Not sure what that says. It doesn't look like. Yeah, it says Giovanni. So that's nice. Very pretty. I like the colors on that. Okay, we have another necklace. That feels like either a seed or some polished wood. You have this bright gold tone chain, which doesn't match the pendant. So it was probably added on after the fact. Okay. Got this little cross pendant. Like the filigree open work on that one. Oh, look at this one. I love that blue. That's very pretty. All the rhinestones are there, so that's good. It's probably just glass. Yep. Very nice. Okay, so we have another Trifari piece. Another pin, silver tone. Kind of looks like a leaf. All right, we have silver tone. Here's a black. Yeah, I'm not sure. It might just be plastic because it doesn't feel cold and it's not moving on the Presidium, so. No maker's mark on that one. Ooh, look at this. Very interesting. So that says Bow Sterling. I'll have to look that up. Little sterling silver leaf pin. Very, I'm gonna say retro looking, honestly, with the way that it looks, but I like that. So I'll test that, see if it is sterling. This feels like plastic. Looks like a bunch of wheat to put together in a little bundle. All right, so we have a rice pearl necklace and bracelet set. I am assuming these are real. They feel real. They are cold. This is a double strand bracelet. And then you have this closure. On the necklace. So, let's sell that as a set if anybody is interested in it. Alright, so this says glass. And, oh, that's the Swarovski swan. So I wonder if these are Swarovski crystals. I would assume they are. So that's nice. You got a little Swarovski crystal bracelet. It is very small. Yeah. I don't even think it would close on my wrist. So I would probably say a 6, maybe. A little smaller than a 6. But very nice. Looks like it's in great condition. I don't see any wear on it. All of the crystals are there. They are beautiful. That's nice. Okay. Not sure if that broke off of. Looks like it was glued to something. So a little, maybe it was a pendant of some sort. This is very gross and lots of verdigris, so this is gonna go in the pile that needs to be taken care of. Let's see. Okay, we have the little infinity knot silver tone necklace. Just a simple little tiny choker style infinity knot necklace, silver tone. Looks like it's in great condition. This one says Western Germany. This is all plastic. Cute little vintage piece. Now we got a big, what is this? Okay, it is all tangled in some necklaces, but look how big. Oh, I did it again. I always hit the phone. I'm sorry. Okay. This thing is massive. Oh, look, we found. I know we found this. What'd we find? The pendant? Or did we find an earring? Because here is the match. Alright, so that's a necklace. This is a necklace. Here's the pin. Yeah, I don't see any markings on it, but it is a big piece. Love the floral design on it. Very nice. It's got some nice weight to it. There's that earring. This is by Crown Trifari. And these just feel like little pieces of glass that look like they've just been smushed. Like they just smushed the glass. Oh no, it's leaves. Kind of looks like little leaves were imprinted in. It's in really good condition. Very nice. Okay. This one has a little grain enamel pendant on it. Gold tone chain. That does have a mark. However, I do not know whose mark that is with two little dots and a square. I'll have to look that up. That is a new one to me. Let's see what these are. Yep, they didn't move, so they're probably just plastic. But I like that one. That one's nice. Okay, let's get these out. We got another one. Very pretty with the pearl. That one does have a stamp, but I can't read it. I think it just says 1/120th gold filled, but very pretty. Yeah, let's get these out. It's neat with the little barrel beads on there. So this pendant has a teeny little rhinestone. It almost looks like something was supposed to go in the middle right there. Yeah, that's glue. Something was supposed to go in the middle right there and was taken out or fell out. Yep, this is going up to almost the ruby, so I'm not sure if that is a little ruby chip in there. I don't see any markings on the chain, so that's neat. We'll have to look into that further. This is just a choker with these little gold barrel beads and these faux pearls. Okay, what is this? It's a peanut. EG ink. Not sure, I'll have to look that up. Cute little peanut with the mouth right there. Reminds me of Mr. Peanut from Planters. Very, to me, it's kind of Southwestern inspired because of the turquoise colored pieces in here and the silver. Very nice pen. I like it. It's different. That's why I like it. Okay, this is by Monet. So it does have these little needle things right here. So I'm not sure maybe if it was supposed to go into a shirt or a scarf or shoes. Okay. We have a set here. Looks like it's by Monet. So we have the bracelet and we have the necklace with this very metallic pendant. Okay, so here's the bracelet, silver tone, very nice. Both pieces are in really good condition. There are some scratches on that pendant, but the chain is in perfect working order. So that looks good. Okay. Running out of room to put stuff. Here we go. Got another one with a faux pearl. Gold tone. Little heart with leaf design. Okay, what is this? So we got a big chunk of something. Not sure what that would be, if it's onyx or what it is. It is on kind of like a rubber cord. It is cold, so it's either glass or maybe onyx. This is plastic. These are all plastic. They have that. I'm not sure what the proper term is, but I refer to this as like oil slick because it has that dark coloring to it. So, just double strand. It's all plastic. This is pretty worn. Lots of verdigris on it. I don't know if it just needs a good cleaning, but very pretty, probably a pendant, or maybe it went on a bracelet. Look at this one. This one's pretty. Look at that. I love that color green. It's very different. I haven't seen anything. This says Austria, made Austria. It is cold. So that's very nice. Love that. We have a Monet pen, gold tone. Maybe a leaf or flower design. And we got these two bags, and yep, that's it. So these two bags look like they have tons of chains. So this is a pendant, little tooth looking pendant. That kind of went to the emerald line. It didn't go to jade because I kind of thought it was, but I don't know. I'll have to look at that some more. We have this pendant with the druzy, probably clear quartz on the inside. Another little pendant with a pearl. And let's see, this one looks out of place. It says Roma. I don't know if that's supposed to say like 1744, 1744. It's a pendant. Yeah, I'll have to look that up. I'm not sure what that means. There's just a pale gold, maybe it was gold and it's just turning silver chain. We have another chain here. It's silver tone, it's a box chain. Another chain with these little odd clasp on them. And let's see, what's this one? We got a little crab necklace, cute little crab pendant. On a silver tone chain. I don't see any makers on it. Very nice. And we have a couple more chains. Let's see. No maker, just a silver tone chain. That's probably like a short choker style. And got one, it's a little longer. And this one is a gold tone. Yeah, so we have a silver and a gold. Same length. We have that silver one. We have the little crab guy. Okay, so that's that for this box. We are at 42 minutes. So let's see what we can this stuff back nicely. Let's see. I do have my I guess you would call it best of jewelry that I kind of want to go through because I forgot to do it, and then I had the issues with the tubes and everything. So what can we do? I may just cut it off here. Let's see. I have the next box right here next to me. Do a little sneak peek. What is this? I have a watch. Sofia Vergara. I wonder how do you get this out? Oh, okay. So it's a cuff style watch. Has probably a mother of pearl face on it. Very pretty. Silver tone, look at all the rhinestones, and they are all there. Doesn't look like it's working, so I don't know if it needs a battery. But it looks like it's in really good condition. So I'm not sure if this box goes with that or not, because it doesn't have her name on that at all. What's this? Oh, Whiting and Davis again. Very nice. Look at this necklace. that looks like tiger's eye. Big chunky pendant. And there is the tag. Here's the matching earrings. It says Whiting and Davis Co. right there. Wow, that's a nice little set. I'll have to look that up. I know Whiting and Davis is it's a pretty good brand, right? I think so. So I will definitely look into that one. I'm gonna move that crystal. Let's see, what else can we get into? Put this back. That's really pretty. So we have this, looks like a copper bracelet. Yep, it says copper right there. So let's see how you open these. They do make it kind of hard, so you don't, I guess, so it doesn't fall off and you don't lose it, but it's very pretty. Very lightweight too, so. Okay, I think we are going to cut it off here, and we're at 46 minutes, so I think we'll cut it off here, and maybe I'll put out another video on Sunday, so that way we can get these estate sale boxes done, so that way we can bust into that Shop Goodwill auction lot that I finally won. I was excited to actually win one, so. I hope you all have a great weekend and have plenty of rest and relaxation and fun times, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.